गुड इवनिंग मैम. ओके सो माय फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन टू यू इज़ द एकेडमिक रिसर्च दैट यू डिड इन योर यूजी इयर्स, हाउ इज़ दैट लिंक्ड टू द प्रोजेक्ट यू डूइंग नाउ एंड डिड इट हेल्प यू एंड इफ यू डिड हाउ डिड इट हेल्प यू एंड द स्किल्स यू लर्न ड्यूरिंग दैट टाइम वेर एबल टू यूज इट नाउ लाइक टू डू योर ड्यू डिलीजेंस एंड टू रिसर्च मोर अबाउट दिस एरिया टू नो इफ समथिंग लाइक दिस इज ऑलरेडी देयर. सो कुड यू टेल अस मोर अबाउट दैट?
To be honest, it's all about like it's interconnected. Okay, it depends on what kind of research are you doing. Like I said, my research, my journal, which I had actually done review paper, academic research, I can say that was related to HIV perception. So it was not very much related to any innovation. So it did not help me personally. But when I actually, it's not like. From academic research, you can go to innovation. Trust me, you can even go from innovation to academic research. So I'll give you one of those examples. When I actually came up with this aerosol thing, so I had this idea. I spoke to some people. That time we were having this pandemic, and I had to get it validated. So I sent it to approximately, I sent a Google Doc to around 100 doctors. Doctors as in dentists, and approximately I had sent it to a lot of them, but 97 of the dentists actually responded, and 75 general people. So I wanted to know the perspective of both of them. Are the common people actually facing an issue? Are they scared to go to the clinic? Do they know about aerosol? Would they be willing to pay extra? Are they scared to enter the clinic? I wanted to know their perception. So I asked separately few questions to the patients, and I consulted few questions for the dentists. Okay, so that was a questionnaire thing. When I did that, the next phase for me was coming up with the solution. So I had validated that my idea is actually the problem which I'm thinking, it is validated. Then I decided, okay, that is done. But when I have to prove it, when I have to actually present, for example, I have to go to BIRAC and I have to present it, I just can't say that I spoke to few people, so it was possible. And I just can't say that, yeah, SARS-CoV-2 is actually supposed to, like, is very infective. So I thought, why not have a journal written on that? Why don't I do a basic research? So I just collaborated with a junior. I approached one of my professors from oral surgery, and we actually did the research as in we went to other places, like other research papers, and we figured out what are the viruses, like how harmful it is, a microbiological aspect, every aspect. And we did the background study, we made a questionnaire, we validated it, we circulated it to, like, we validated it by two doctors in Mangalore. And I did not send it to just general medicine people just because I know them. I sent it to a professor from microbiology and one professor from medicine to know what is their individual perspective. And after that, I actually wrote a paper. I could not get it, I could not go to the ethical committee, scientific committee, because my internship got over by then. So my junior will be taking forward the project. But that's how I actually went from my innovation to a research paper. Because in the research paper, I wanted to say what are the things which can actually deactivate the protein of the virus. So it can be other way around. And definitely, if I would have maybe done a research paper before about the virus, or maybe about the aerosols or the infection spread, I could go back to my innovation. So it's always interconnected. So you can't actually say that academic research takes you there or that will take you here. It's just like both way around. So you can interconnect always.
Thank you for that. And my next question is, can you tell us more about Mutbi and Karnataka Bio Incubator and some of the other incubators in Mahi and how it has helped you? And,
okay. What so they do? Talking about Mutbi, so Mutbi is basically Manipal University Technology Business Incubator. So basically, I applied for Nidhi IR. I have a page for that. I'll again share my screen. I have taken out these few pages. Okay, so you can see my screen, I hope. You can see my screen, right?
Yeah, no.
So this is about Nidhi. So I can tell you guys, it is a very, very good opportunity. So this is basically an entrepreneurship in residence program. A lot of people do it after their right after their graduation. You can do it at a later time as well, but it is good if you do right after your graduation. So as a student, you can't take up this program actually. So since I had recently graduated in October, I took up this thing, and the call had started in October, I think. And January 1st, I got the fellowship, okay? So it is a fellowship thing in which it provides you a lot of opportunities in which you have a incubation center. So I selected my incubation center as Mutbi, because I could work closely with Innovation Center and so and my team. So Mutbi is also very, very well known, and it has been here for a long time. And being a Mahe student, I always preferred anything related to Mahe. So as you can see, these are the PEP known as Program Execution Partners, and Mutbi is one of them. And Venture Center Pune is also an incubator. And what these incubators do is they provide you some mentorship. Like I said, I had some issues with finance. So they arranged a session, a workshop kind of a thing, and I'll be getting a talk, and all of us will get to know about that. They tell you how to start up a company, what are the types of company, and how you can actually pursue your entrepreneurship journey. So basically, it is meant for all potential innovators and who are actually planning to go ahead and open their own company. So the benefits you get is you get a stipend of 10,000 to 30,000. Maximum is 30,000. And depending on your work and your innovation potential and everything, they give you this amount. And it might improve if you are doing really well. So you have to have some milestones, and you have to achieve those milestones, and the amount can decrease or increase based on your work efficiency. So it is given for a period of 12 months, and every month you'll get a 10,000 to 30,000 amount, and you get an office space, you get a support from their side, and they tell you about funding linkages. They tell you how you can actually go ahead and meet some investors. They basically prepare you for the outer world, and I think that is something which is actually much needed, because if I was supposed to go to the market now, I would not know which person to go ahead and ask, because I can't start a company right now. I can't build a prototype from my own pocket after my internship. So I am receiving this stipend, and with that fellowship amount, I am buying the raw materials, and we are getting our work done, prototype development. But this is not enough for you to open up a company. They just prepare you for opening a company. So after this, I have to open up a company. So they tell you where you can go. So they guided me, like, you can, in future, you can go for angel investors, and later on seed fundings. And then there will be other ventures where you can approach. But starting stage, you have to go with the angel investors. In my case, I am preferring BIREC. PIG right now, and I might get, if I get selected for National Innovation Contest, I might get some amount of funding from there, from which I'm actually planning to start my, at least register my company. So regarding other grants, because you might be thinking, how will you actually open? I can suggest you this BIREC. It has a lot of things, okay? As a student, right after your graduation or during your PG times, you can't do all these things during your college life actually. So after your college is done, you can apply for these things, and it has the thing biomedical device and diagnostics. So mine was related to that, so I applied for this. You can see, or you asked me about other incubation partners, right? So like I said, your one is BioNest. In my you have Bio Incubator, which has recently come up. So it's not just Mutbi, there's another one known as Bio Incubator, which has come up. And you can actually go for, like, I have applied through Venture Center Pune for my BIREC. So there are different things, like a lot of things. If I keep talking, it will be like a lengthy thing. But there's something known as a funding partner, there is something known as incubating partner. So for BIREC BIG, I have taken funding partner as Venture Center Pune, and have selected incubation partner as Mutbi. So I know I've been working with Moodbee, my team is here, so I can stay here and work, and funding can be done by another person, another institute. So it's a very good thing. Like, if you are planning to start your company, BIDAC is one of the best thing. It's not easy to get, trust me. It's very difficult and it's a very lengthy procedure. And once if you get it, if your company goes in profit, you might have to pay them some 5% and all, only if your company is in profit. If your company goes in loss, you can shut down your company right away and you can end. You will not have to pay anything. So initially getting, they will give you in installments. It's not like they'll give you 50 lakhs ek bar mein. They will give you in three installments. So even if you get 15 lakhs in your first installment, you have to produce bills and everything. So if you get a 15 lakhs grant only for building up your company, your prototype, your payment for other people, your marketing, website, all these things, I think that's a huge amount and that's a huge boost up for you to actually go ahead. So I always felt like I was not losing on anything. Trust me, when I actually started with my innovation, till now I have not invested anything from my pocket. When I made the first prototype, it was funded by Innovation Center. Trust me, if you are doing any project, any contest which is organized by Innovation Center, they also give you some grants for building your prototype. You have to produce the bills and GST bills, and they actually give you a fund. I received around 10,000 for my first prototype, and I received 25,000, I don't exactly remember, for my since I was declared the winner for Manipal COVID challenge. So that was like those 25 were like extra. Mujhe pure prototype ka to mil gaya tha, prototype amount se. So around 30,000 I received from Innovation Center that time. Later, when I built my second prototype and all other process, I received funding from Nidhi IR stipend. So I have been working on my project because of that. And by God's grace, if I get NIC amount or BIRAC, I can go ahead. So I'm not losing on anything, I feel. So don't be scared. Don't be scared. Don't fear like, kaise hoga, kya hoga. You will get away. Trust me. It's not like you can't. There is no barrier. You have everything. All options are available, so just go for it if you have anything in your mind.
Thank you for that. Thank you for that. Just a quick question. When it comes to the incubators and the seed funding by BIRAC Nidhi, you don't lose any equity, right? It's you retain all your equity, right? Like you own 100% of your company right now, right? In case you start it? Or do you have to let go of equity when you take funding from these incubators?
No, you don't have to. Like I'll tell you, when I am here at Nidhi, you have to pay a basic amount. For example, I'm using their office and everything, right? So I have to pay them 12.5%. And it's very, very informed to you. So how much ever amount you are getting, out of that 12.5%, you have to give to Moodbee for the facilities which you are seeking. I get free Wi-Fi. I get a office here. I get to work with all their equipment. And by the way, I forgot to inform you, Innovation Center, I don't know if you guys have visited, you all should visit when you are here. We have a maker space, we have labs, we have chambers here where you can actually go and work for prototype development. You have a room where there is a lot of wood and everything and you can work with that. So all facilities are here and you just need to go there, and the maker space is awesome, trust me. So you should actually visit the Innovation Center. So I utilize all these things, right? And they are actually arranging talks for us and getting everything organized. So for that, for the management part, we charge you 12.5%. And when it comes to BIRAC, since they are paying you, definitely they expect something in return, right? But once you open your company and you have a profit, only then they are asking you for a percentage. Otherwise, they are not. They are like, if your company goes in loss or you just plan to dismiss your company, they will not ask you for it. It's like no risk. If you take a loan or if you take it from angel investors, trust me, it is a lot of headaches. So for first stage, if you're not very confident about your venture, always go for government funds, I'll suggest. BIRAC is one of them. It's a government fund thing. So go for an incubation in your initial stage, because you never know where your venture will be, and you just can't take risk of starting, like taking help of an angel investor, because you don't even know them, right? At least when you are at an incubation center, you know you are getting things from the right source, right people, and you won't be ditched anyway. So that is one thing you will not lose. Just take a safe thing, and by the time you actually get over with your incubation, you are a little polished and everything, you learn how to recognize people, you know how to approach people. That time you can actually take such things when your company is at a initial growth stage. Then you can go for angel investment, seed investment. But at this stage, when you are just at a prototype development or early innovation, never go for those things. That is what I would suggest.
Okay, thank you. That was very insightful. And the last question I have is, what is next for you and your team? Like, what are your future plans? And what do you want to do next?
To be honest, I'm just letting life unfold the way it is coming my way. But if you ask about my plans, I think it would be nice to mention about this person. So the company I'm working in, Meritos, I mentioned about it. I think he introduced about that. So it's a edtech company. Like, you people have Marrow, right? So it's a similar kind of thing for dental students. So I had this question, if I should go ahead with MDS or I should go ahead with entrepreneurship, because definitely entrepreneurship like holds some kind of risk, and so this CEO, he asked me to do that, and I applied for my NEET and I cleared that. I qualified. Next was Nidhi. I'm still at it, and NEET MDS was conducted, but counseling was not done. Like, it has not been done till now. So if the counseling happens, I'll appear for that. I'll keep that in my hand as well. Right. I'm just waiting for BIRAC. If I get good opportunity, and by September, if I get BIRAC, because final round will be around August, September. If I get BIRAC, I have two paths with me. If I get BIRAC, I'm going ahead. I'm going to start my company. I have a team here, and my plan is to go ahead and address the problems in healthcare. Like I told you people, I will interact with more doctors, and I'll try to know what are the issues they are facing, like not only in the hospital or OPD, even in the dental clinics or in their private clinics. Maybe some ophthalmologist, he's facing some issue in his clinic. So I would like to just go talk to people, the nurses. I visited the endoscopy department and I got to know nurses are facing so many issues. So my plan is to actually go ahead and find out the problems, talk to people, because I feel nobody is doing that in our sector. Like, none of the doctors or dentists or any healthcare professional is actually going ahead, and because I know the problem, I will be able to solve it in a better way, because I knew that this aerosol is causing an issue, and how I am working on a patient, and how much of a thing will be required, how much distance would be needed, and what all other issues. Since I know that department, that field, I'm able to do it. So I think a doctor or a dentist or any healthcare professional can be the best person to address the problem. So address all the health to start a company, and we would go ahead with medical devices or making basically medical sector easy. This is one plan, and if I don't get that, I always have a backup ready. I'll go ahead with my MDS. I'll go fund myself, I'll start my company. But I'm definitely not giving up on my entrepreneurship journey. But yeah, that is the thing. So I have both the things ready. So I would suggest all of you keep backups so that you don't fall. If you have backups, you'll know you're not losing on anything. So just go ahead it's not difficult. Everything is difficult, to be honest. And trust me, MBBS or MDMS is much tougher than any of these. So just believe it's easy and you will find a way.
Yeah, that was
Okay, I think
very inspiring. Vishnu, you were saying something?
yeah, thank you, Dr. Mahima. I think we can conclude the interview now. That on behalf
Thank
of
you. Yes.
the whole of KMC-SRF, I want to thank Dr. Mahima for dedicating her time out of her day to share us insights into her journey in innovation and research, and hopefully inspire students of KMC Manipal and students everywhere to who want to pursue research or innovation and who just needed this confidence. And thanks for sharing all the resources, and that was
It was my
really
pleasure,
helpful.
and I would just share my screen. I'll share my email ID so that if any of you ever want to approach me, just drop me a mail. Okay, let me just, yeah. So these are my email IDs, and you can, if you are a Manipal student, you can always approach me on this one. As you'll know, we are all available on Teams, so you can always approach me on the second email ID. Others can approach me on the first email ID. And I'm very active, and this is my LinkedIn profile. If you really want to connect or discuss your idea, I'm always here, and feel free. And I'll be more than happy to help any healthcare professional, like motivate or help you get there, or any resource I can do. Okay, and I'm here at Manipal. If you guys are here or you need any help or if you have any idea and you want to know how to go ahead with it, please feel free to approach me. I'll always help you. Thank you so much,
Sure.
Vishnu and team, for inviting me for this. And it was a
Much.
pleasure to be here and address all you doctors.
Thank you
And I
very
really
much.
hope
Thank you,
it's
ma'am. Yeah.
helpful for you guys. And I want to see one of you coming up as an innovator in future.
Thank you.
Trust me, believe it is
Yeah.
possible.
Yes, and it was really helpful. We got to learn a lot of things that we wouldn't have had we approached a faculty or
Absolutely, ma'am.
anybody in the senior position. So at the ground level, the student level, the insights you gave us, I think those were very valuable. The Discord group especially,
Yeah.
we'll definitely look into that.
Please spread about that, and
Yes.
I will just forward the links to you, Vishnu.
Yeah,
Sh
sure.
share it with your friends, and if they can join, and I just hope it's like we just want everyone to know about it, and
Sure.
we don't know, right? And that can be very helpful, actually. If you need any skill set of people, just go to the need help or just approach me. If you face any issue, feel free to approach me. I'll tell you how to go ahead with that. And since I'm here since a long time, I know a lot of departments, like how you can approach or streamline how you can go and apply for grants. You still have a long way to go, though, but you can start your innovation right now in your college days. And trust me, if you dedicate half an hour every day, it's not impossible. Now I feel like, oh my God, why did I just spend time reading all my college life? Dedicate some time for yourself, your hobbies, and everything, and you can do great. So,
Thank you very much, and I wish you all the best for
thank you
your
very
endeavors
much.
and
Thanks
ventures.
so much. Thanks a
Yeah.
lot.
Okay.
So we'll
And I
just
think
accept.
we'll conclude.
Yeah, we'll conclude
Yeah.
later.
Yeah.
Okay,
Bye.
guys, if there's anything, approach me, no issues, and कुछ भी जानना हो पूछ लेना. And विश नु जस्ट रिमाइंड मी, मे बी टुमारो आई जस्ट शेयर दोज इम्पोर्टेंट लिंक्स विद यू
Yeah, thanks a
अबाउट
lot.
डिस्कॉर्ड एंड अदर ग्रुप्स. आई जस्ट कंपाइल ऑल द टेलीग्राम ग्रुप्स एंड एवरीथिंग, सो यू कैन सर्कुलेट इट अमंगस्ट योर फ्रेंड्स एंड
Okay.
दे कैन जॉइन मे बी.
Sure.
ठीक है,
We'll do.
ओके गाइस,
Thanks a lot.
बाय,
Bye.
टेक केयर.
Thank you for watching, and for more such videos, don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel and hit the bell icon.